Hopefully I could get all these in here because I'm starving, y'all. I've been busting out the videos and I've been eating a lot of fish. Got him, yeah. Oh, that's a good fish, baby. Let's go, let's go. That's the one, baby, yeah. Nice fatty. You guys know how we hook them, right in the corner of the lip. There you go, that's my first fillet. Go on the other side, that's probably the best fillet I ever made in my life, y'all. Look at that mangrove snapper right there, y'all. We got cream corn and rice. Steamed mixed veg, broccoli, cauliflower, carrot, and then the star of our show, baby. Look at that flaky white mangrove snapper. Let's see if we can hold it up for you. Oh yeah, look at that, guys.
Alrighty, guys, I came out to my bridge in Key Biscayne. I scored two nice snappers for the catch and cook of this video. It's about a storm on me right now. I'm not sure if I'm about to do this catch and cook right here on the beach or at home in my yard or something, guys. But stick around, y'all, for another lit video, baby.
Alrighty, guys, today I'm gonna be going with my 4000 FX series Shimano combo, Aeroglass combo to be exact. It's a 7-foot one piece rod. And then for my rig, I'm gonna be kind of like freelining, but I just added that 8-ounce weight like I always do. Put 2 to 3 foot of 10-pound mono between the weight and the hook. And then I got a size 6 mustad hook, just like this. For bait, I still had like, I would say 5 to 7 pounds max of pilchards, goggle eyes, all type of little sardines and things. I'm gonna be trying to use those today, guys. And that's my rig, bait, and rod for this video. Hopefully we could catch something to keep. Looking to do a little small catch and cook, you know. I like those catch and cooks right here on the beach side. It's a beautiful thing every time. So I want to continue to keep those going for y'all because I know y'all like those videos. Hopefully the audio for this video is a lot better, guys, because I changed my camera. I actually came out today to do a catch and cook as well as test my new GoPro out. So I'm working on all those things that you guys mentioned in the comments, like audio, sound, the quality of certain things. I'm working on it, y'all. Y'all just give me time. I'm only human. I'm one guy. I'm posting every 2 days, at least 3 times a week, and you guys can see for the past 4 months. So I can't be like a machine in all aspects because some of these areas like editing and things are still kind of new to me. But I'm always learning and investing, guys. So behind the scenes, I'm making a lot of moves to improve the quality of this content for you guys' satisfaction. But without any more talking, let's get into some fishing, baby. Let's do it. Yeah. I'm a freaking cornball, dude. All right, y'all, what I'm doing now is I'm just taking my scissors and cutting these little pilchards, the smaller size ones, or whatever size one I can actually get my hand on, in some chunks, very small size chunks for chum. I'm throwing like 5 to 10 pieces of those each, and I'm cutting each pilchard in like 5 to 6 pieces. The pilchards that I'm preparing are also, I'm just cutting the head and the tail off and using that nice plug. So I'm just preparing some baits right here, y'all. These smaller little jacks or whatever they are, I'm using those for whole baits because they stay on the hook a lot better. But the pilchards stay on as well when you salt them. I'm still looking forward to doing that video for you guys. I just have to go back and catch some more baits to be able to do that video. I can't salt already salted baits, but y'all know that. So I'm gonna just continue to cut some of this up. When I get a nice amount, then I'll start casting. Alright, y'all, I got my nice little mountain of baits right here, as you guys can see. And then I got these ones that I'm gonna be using to put on the hook. These are my chum. Just like that, y'all. Get one of these on the hook and maybe 5 to 6 pieces of baits in my hand. Throw those out first. Then once I start seeing the fish coming out, I just throw mine right behind them. always behind them, not in front of them for me. I don't think it really matters because it's gonna drift depending on the current, but for me, I like it behind them because I notice the bigger fish are always a little bit later to come to the party. Got him. Oh yeah, got him. Get up here, dude. Whoo, yeah. Oh, freaking A, dude, that's a nice one, guys. And he just threw my bait at me. Look, he's throwing up. He's trying to get rid of that hook, but he don't understand. He just volunteered for the catch and cook. He's trying to get rid of that hook, but he just volunteered for the catch and cook. Oh, he's definitely 10 in my book. Let's see right now. Make sure if he's 10 in the metric system. Oh yeah, look at that, yo. 10 goes here. He's easily 10 and a half. Easily 10 and a half inch mangrove, y'all. Look at that. Hooked perfectly right in the corner of the lip. You know how the professionals do it. I'm just kidding, y'all. I mess around too much, dude. But look at that beautiful fish. Like I said, y'all, we testing out the GoPro today. Brand new camera. And we just trying to see if we can't get us a little catch and cook. I'm gonna get this guy under some ice because I'm probably gonna try to get the filleted meat off of this guy. I might not be cooking them whole today, so let's get them in the cooler. Just like that, under some ice. Oh, whoa, whoa, that guy tried getting me, huh? Easy, pal. Got a trick for you in a couple minutes. All right, y'all, that's one. Let's get some more. All right, y'all, I got a nice small handful of chum. Throw that out right there. Then I'm gonna go right behind them with mine. Just like that. Let that sink a little bit. Give it some slack so when the fish takes it, he can run a ways. I think I got picked up. Oh yeah, I got picked up. I got picked up, baby. Heck yeah, just that simple, just that easy, y'all. Nice little 9-inch mango. Look at that, guys. Let's get this guy back. Easy, pal. Don't try to bite me, you're going back. How in the heck did you hook yourself here? Let's go, man, let go. Come on, buddy, let go. My hand is dangerously close to his mouth. Nice little fish. Later, pal. Down to the bottom. Got him, yeah. Oh, that's a good fish, baby. Come on. Heck yeah. Let's go. That's the one, baby. Yeah. That's the one. Heck yeah. That's our second volunteer, guys. I probably had an hour of fishing between those two fish, those two keepers that I needed for this catch and cook. I'm gonna get this guy on some ice. Probably get him cleaned up on or off cam. I'm not sure, guys. Just stick around. I might even get one more. For all the work I put in, I deserve a nice meal. Look at that guy. Let's get a measurement on him. Oh yeah, 11 all day. 10 is right here, 10 goes here. Check that out, guys. He's 11 all day. Nice fatty. You guys know how we hook him, right in the corner of the lip. One more look at that fish while we get him in the box. I want him under some ice. All right, y'all, we got two of them. Two nice fish. Get them under those ice just like that. Pour some water down there at the bottom of my cooler. Let them sit in that nice bed of that water. just like that, y'all. And I could get everything back inside. Now I know we have enough fish for the catch and cook, but let's see if I can't get one more, make it a little bit better. All right, guys, we didn't do too bad at all. We got two 10 and a half mangrove snapper. Nothing too shabby. One might be 11, 10 and a half, 11, whatever. Don't matter. I'm going to try to fillet these guys up right now. See how bad or good I am. I know I'm not good at this. I'm normally one to cook my fish fried whole. So let's just see. I know for sure this is the wrong knife for this, but it's okay. We're gonna make do with what we got today. Outline my fish. Open it up. Run the knife along those backbones. Just like that. Over the rib cage. Poke your knife all the way through at some point. Leave the tail still semi-connected. Turn your knife, remove your fillet, turn it over. I'm a righty, so I'm gonna go this way with it. Start cutting down a little bit, then you wanna drag it. Rock your knife slightly, but you want to pull the skin of that fish just like that. As you do it, rock your knife, pull the skin. There you go, that's my first fillet. Go on the other side. That's probably the best fillet I ever made in my life, y'all. Y'all helped me be a lot better in this life, I'm telling you, in a bunch of different ways. Now turn it this way. Start my cut, outline my fish. If this knife allows me to start outlining. There we go. Just like that. Open her up, run the knife along that spine, just like that. Point it downward so I can get all my meat out of that son of a gun. Press down on her. Run the knife up and out through that same cut, over those rib bones. That. Keep running it over those rib bones a little bit more. Push it down. Poke my knife through. Just like that. Just like that, y'all. Separate that. Run my knife through. Back towards the tail, but leave it still attached. Just like that. Slap that guy over. Pull all of this out of the way. Start cutting downward and then turn your knife at an angle.
Want this bait, partner?
Huh?
Want this bait?
Bait? I'll take some for sure. Thanks, brother.
Catch him up. I just wanted one for me and one for my son. We got two snappers. I'm down.
Thank you, sir. All right, guys. That's my first one right there. It's my first fish. Find those pin bones. Cut those out. Straight through my fish like that. Found one more right here at the beginning. Get rid of that. I'll just take this whole section off. Just like that. That's one nice fillet. Go on the other side, do the same thing. halfway through your fillet, you're gonna find pin bones. Cut those out. On this one, I still got the rib cage, so I'm gonna just go underneath that at an angle just like this. Get as much meat as I can off those things. And those are my two fillets, y'all. Just like this. Two beautiful fillets, actually. Probably my best two fillets ever. I'm showing off on cam, y'all, for y'all. Look at that. Nice mangrove snapper fillet. There's the carcass. I still got both pieces of the skin on. As you guys can see, throw that back in the water along with these bones and these other little pieces. And then I'll get that other fish filleted, and then I'll see you guys when it's time to cook. Look at that, y'all. I got my four nice boneless mangrove snapper fillets. I'm telling you guys, this has to be my best fillet job in life. I really don't fillet fish at all. Not only because I don't really know how, at least I watch 100,000 videos on it, I just don't think my fish are big enough. That's the main reason, but also because I don't know how, y'all, for real. But I've been watching, I've been studying, I've been doing my research, and I think I'm getting better at it. Look at that, y'all. I wouldn't say that was too bad if I don't say so myself. Alrighty, guys, I'm at home now. I decided to do this catch and cook the next day at home. So that's why you see my fish. They're a little bit white here. These are the same snapper, guys. You know, I keep it 100% real. I just did this video a day in between. This morning, I went out and caught the bait to do my next video, which will be the how to salt and preserve your bait, your pilchards and sardines video. So without any further ado, guys, for the flies eat me up or eat up all my fish, I got those mangrove snapper that I caught. I got my propane cooker right here. I got my pan right here. Olive oil, lemon juice, and salt and pepper, guys. And I already got two sides that you guys will see when I plate these. I got cream corn mixed with rice, and I got mixed veg. I'm gonna be using those as sides for these, but I already had those as leftovers from my dinner last night. I wanna finish off those sides as well as finish off these fish. So I decided keep the rest of the sides and then do another meat, cause I had chicken yesterday. I'm gonna cook these snapper. Same thing, different day. So let's get into it, y'all. So I'm gonna turn on the gas. We got fire, baby, just like that. You could even use matches for this, for those of you that don't know, but I'm pretty sure most of you know that already. So I'm gonna take my pan, set that on there. I don't think I need a lid for this. I just want to cook these fish thoroughly. Salt, pepper, that's all I'm gonna do. So right now what I'm gonna do is step back a little bit. Wake that salt up a little bit. Whoa, that's too much. I might want to go in my hand. Salt these a little bit. Flip them over, salt the other side. That's the water burning off of there. I could turn this down a bit. Layer that with some oil. That bad boy cooks quick, y'all. Let's turn that way down. Move this around some. Don't pop me, I'm shirtless. Let's turn that down. We got oil in there, a little bit of salt on that first side of the fish. Put a little bit more on the other side. Just like that. Now, pepper. Just salt and pepper, y'all. Most fish, if you really just use salt and pepper, you'll actually taste the flavor of each individual fish. Most fish have their own taste. Let me adjust this down a little bit more. That's too high. That bad boy start cooking quick. And I don't want to set my fish in there when it's that high, so I'm gonna turn it down as low as I can get it before I turn it off, which I just did. Like a barnacle head, I gotta relight it. There it is. I want it as low as it can get, guys. That oil's already piping hot. So yeah, just salt, pepper a little bit right there on these fish. Now I'm gonna just lay them in there. Oh yeah, this thing's hot as hell. Hopefully I could get all these in here because I'm starving, y'all. I've been busting out the videos and I've been eating a lot of fish. which is good. Both of those statements are actually good. I'm getting a lot better at filleting fish too, y'all. Let that oil get in between all. Make sure these not stacked. Look at that, baby. Oh yeah. Crank that up a little bit. Ooh, I wish y'all could smell this. Look at that, y'all. Make sure the corners of your fish are all oiled, so that way it's gonna be nice and crispy when it's done. Now I could crank this up a little bit higher, just a tad bit higher. Oh yeah, that works. Right there, baby. Now I'm gonna cap this off for a bit, guys. Maybe 2-3 minutes max. Make sure it's centered so it don't fall and burn me. Just like that. All right, y'all. I'm gonna give these fish the first turn. Oh, they're already falling apart. Whoa. These bad boys falling apart. That's not a problem though. There, guys, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take and put my lemon juice in. I'm gonna just put a little bit of this. I don't know what's a little bit to y'all, but I like to coat the bottom of the pan with the lemon juice so that way the fish absorbs that oil and it comes to like a nice little boil, if you guys can see. Look at that. So what I like to do is just go a little bit of oil more. Hit it with a little bit of more salt and pepper. Make sure the salt, okay, the salt's coming out right. I'm gonna go a little bit heavier on the salt because we got lemon juice in there, guys, and we don't want it just tangy. You know, lemon's a little bit tangy, so we don't want it all tangy. And then we can leave the juice in the pan when it's done cooking. I'm gonna let this sit for another 3 to 4 minutes while I run inside and get my sides, my cream corn and rice, and my mixed veg. I'll probably plate that up, and then I'll get back to you guys when I got this out of here and plate it up. Oh, I'll probably plate it up with you guys. Give me a second, y'all. All right, y'all. I think it's about time to get our fish out of here. Let's check, make sure. Oh yeah, nice and flaky. I went inside and got my sides, y'all. Plate this up. Decided to plate it up with you guys, show y'all how I show you guys how I like to do it. It doesn't matter to me if these pieces come out small, y'all. I just want a nice mountain of fish. Mangrove snapper, one of those flaky ones, when they get cooked, they kind of start to get wild. Look at that, y'all. All right, guys, we did that. Let me move all this stuff out the way. Show you guys my plate. Look at that mangrove snapper right there, y'all. Hoo-hoo-wee. We got cream corn and rice, mixed veg, steamed mixed veg, broccoli, cauliflower, carrots, and then the star of our show, baby. Look at that flaky white mangrove snapper. Let's see if we can hold it up for you. Oh yeah, look at that, guys. Alrighty, guys, I just finished cooking. As you can see, I got my cream corn and rice, my mixed veg, and the star of the show, my mangrove snapper, all right there. As you guys can see, trying my best to record this, y'all, but I wanted to try it with you guys like I always do, so here it is. Let me see if I can balance the plate, show you guys that. Look at that, baby. Hoo-hoo-hoo. Let's break it and show you the middle. Bow. Look how white that is. Hope the camera's picking that up. Once again, guys, I did hear your comments and I did hear everything you guys put about the audio, so I decided to clear out those two birds with one stone, do audio and footage. So I bought a new camera, y'all. Let's see how you like it. Comment down below if you like it, but let's try this fish.
It's real good, y'all. Boneless, nice, brown it on one side, and on the other side we left it white. Oh yeah. One more look at that, y'all. That's my plate, baby. But I'm gonna be finishing up my food, guys. I'm mad tired. I got a couple content creations coming on the way. I love and appreciate you guys, and peace, y'all. See you in the next one.